Zion Williamson, the 19-year-old 6'6", 285-pound phenom, who's taking the NBA by storm. Faithful viewer, I'm a lot like you. I, too, am annoyed by mainstream media's obsession with talking about LeBron and Zion 24/7. But in terms of the hype around Zion, a lot of it is warranted. Through 15 games in his rookie season, the kid is averaging 24.1 points, 6.8 rebounds, and 2.1 assists on a remarkable 59.3% shooting. He's still a teenager, but Zion is bullying grown men in the paint night in and night out. With the way he dominates offensively with his size, strength, and athleticism, he has drawn comparisons to Charles Barkley and even Shaquille O'Neal. Those comparisons may seem a little bold, but they're actually very accurate. Again, Zion is putting up 24.1 points on 59.3%. Guess who the last two players were who exceeded those numbers in a season? Yep, you guessed it. It was a young Shaq in the 1994 season and a prime Charles Barkley in the 1990 NBA season. Now again, this is only 15 games in for Zion, which is just a small sample size. But coming off of a significant injury as a rookie, I don't think it's far-fetched to suggest that he could sustain these numbers or even improve them over the next several years. What makes Zion so special is his combination of power, mass, strength, leaping ability, and grace finishing around the rim, which is a unique combination that the league has never seen before. I like the Charles Barkley comparison, but it doesn't quite fully encompass Zion's traits. Even Barkley has said that Zion is more athletic than he was. In my opinion, Zion is like Charles Barkley, equipped with a Sean Kemp dunk package, 59.3%. I know I'm focusing a lot on this aspect, but it's a big deal. If he continues to shoot with that efficiency, then he changes the modern analytics, and all of a sudden, the three-pointer is not the more efficient shot. This isn't new either. Zion shot a stupid 68% in college. The dude is almost a sure thing anytime he gets to the paint. As I mentioned earlier, that level of efficiency is along the lines of prime Charles Barkley efficiency. A concern of mine, though, is that Zion could be pressured into becoming the Charles Barkley of the long ball. In a sense, Barkley is statistically the worst three-point shooter of all time. Of all the players who ever shot at least 1,000 three-pointers over their career, no one has ever shot as poorly as Barkley's 26.6%. Zion currently isn't taking that many three-pointers, but most of the league is about that now, and he will likely experience pressure to shoot more threes. Zion could learn an outside shot, but I wouldn't want him to turn into one of those guys who forces up jump shots just because he's open, even when he's terrible at them. I'm not saying he is terrible at them, I'm just saying he's not taking that many of them right now, and I think that's okay. Russell Westbrook is another example. The guy has been in the league for 12 seasons. He shoots a very inaccurate 30% from three-point range over his career, and he's shooting 25% this season. He's not getting any better, and he hasn't figured it out. Now understand, Russell Westbrook is one of my favorite players. I love his intensity and his attitude that reminds me of 90s basketball. But I'm not gonna lie, it drives me nuts when I see a player like Westbrook and Barkley who shoots 25% from three, yet he's taking so many three-point shots. That's what I don't want for Zion. He's bigger and stronger than everyone else, and he can elevate higher. Yes, I believe he should take it to the rim, each and every single time. I don't care if they play off of him. No one has an answer for him in the paint. At times, Zion simply looks like a compact version of Shaq. You don't tell mini Shaq to stand outside and take jumpers. You tell him to go down to the paint every time, where he's expected to dominate. If there is a part of Zion's game that he should work on, it's not his 22-footers, it's his 15-footers. An athlete with his hops, his strength, and his ability to finish at the rim is going to be fouled a lot. He's currently shooting a poor 64.8% from the free throw line. If Zion can become a lethal and dependable free throw shooter, then he may just become the most dominant player in the game. Also, any great shooter will tell you that improving your shooting skills on the inside will naturally improve your shooting skills on the outside. If Zion can prioritize his free throw shooting and improve there, that will naturally make him a better shooter anywhere. With the way Zion plays, staying healthy will be his biggest challenge. But if he can manage that, the kid is easily on his way to be one of, if not the most dominant player in the game. Let me know in the comments section where you think Zion's ceiling is, and let me know who you think should be the rookie of the year, him or Ja Morant. Thanks for watching as always. Make sure to like and subscribe for more NBA content, and I'll see you guys in the next video.